I think a lot of people were like, it's a pretty wild idea, pretty crazy. But I think to the people close to me and my family, they realize they're like, actually, there's nothing he'd rather be doing, you know, and there's no way he's not going to do this.
This is the cold parasaur. Tell me that's not what you think about when you hear about the Tour de France. This is like so nice.
I kind of play down the difficulty of it because I don't want to make anyone worried. But I knew, like inside myself, that like it was going to be incredibly difficult. And the more research that we did on the route and the distances, it became pretty apparent that, to me anyway, that it was something that like definitely wasn't a sure thing that I could make it, and that it would require me to like basically be on my A game and really. Really focused and basically be pushed to my limit in some way every day, which like it's a daunting thing to throw yourself into, but it's also like for me that's very motivating.
It's like the thickest, dampest dew, and everything is just soaked. My clothes are so wet.
My process was basically I'd have an idea of how far I was going to try and get the next day, and then using like the Google Maps or whatever, you can see like, okay, maybe there's a campground here at 250K, and then there's another campground at 300K that are sort of on my route. And oh, there's a small town like 10Ks before that campground, which looks of decent size. Maybe I can find some food there. And that was sort of the extent of it, looking one day ahead. And then a lot of guesswork. It's definitely a lot more personal, and like you're very much in your own head, and you're not racing against competitors. You're just kind of trying to manage like your physical ability and your mental state over like a really extended period of time. So it's very unique and different than the challenge of like racing a Grand Tour. It's also, for me anyway, it's a lot more rewarding when you're able to make it work, because you have like a much better connection with the place you're riding through, the people who live there, and then even just the landscape itself. You know, if you're covering all of the terrain under your own power, you really feel the difference between, you know, the mountains and then the big like farming areas and the cities, and you have a much more complete experience, I think. Rolling onto the Champs-Élysées and seeing it all in the middle of the night was like, it just made it very real. Finishing, it was great, but ultimately it's like the experience of doing it is the reward, if that makes sense. So every day, I had that feeling at the end of each day when I would stop, and like a sense of achievement of, you know, the distance I covered, the things I'd overcome, the people I'd met. I was really thankful to have had the whole experience.